So, first of all, welcome everybody today. It's fantastic to see so many people here. Organisations who have supported us right from the beginning and some newer ones that are coming on this journey with us. So to give you a bit of context, my name is Grace Duthie, I'm the Chair of Investors in Care Risk, so I'm doing a bit of a welcome here today. And as you can tell, this is not on a regular basis. So the journey to where we are started about 2 years ago now with a patient's story that came to the Norfolk Police CCG governing body, and it was Fatima who came to tell us about her experiences of being a carer. From that meeting was a commitment to create a carer's charter, and we pulled together a nice little task and finish group and anticipated something that we'd be able to get sorted, you know, a couple of meetings get done by Christmas. We are here 2 years later, and that quick piece of work did not end up being a quick piece of work. I think Fatima, Portia and Lyndon, who have all been key parts of this, will agree this has been a labour of love. And we've spent a significant amount of hours, I wouldn't like to add them up, but it's probably running into the hundreds, working with all our fantastic partners and carers to create what you have all got in front of you today. Here's what I prepared earlier. We've had some fantastic successes so far as investing in carers. We have appointed a board of directors, which sounds really easy and is actually probably more challenging than anyone's realised. But what this has done is this has brought together individuals who've got a real passion for changing the way that carers experience the world. We were a finalist for a Health Service General Award. So earlier on this year, we went to a fantastic award ceremony where there were so many brilliant pieces of work. Unfortunately, we weren't successful, but what it did do is show us that everyone's taking this really, really seriously and that carers are at the forefront of the agenda at the minute. And finally, we've secured funding. We have funding to be able to continue to take this great piece of work forward. It's brilliant to see that so many people believe in the Charter and are willing to put money where their mouth is, literally. So we have some big objectives to deliver over the next 12 months, but I'm sure that everybody in this room will help us on that journey. One of the strengths of the Charter was the fact that it was developed locally, and when it went to Health and Wellbeing Board, one of the comments was it's fantastic to see something that's been created in Kirklees by the people of Kirklees, for the people of Kirklees. But Kirklees is not an island, and there is no way that we can carry on the work that we're doing unless we link it with what big, important national pieces of work are, one of which is the Carers Toolkit. Now, I'm going to come and tell us a little bit more about the Carers Toolkit and how the Carers Charter can link with this. But one of the things I just wanted to leave before I hand over to Neil is a big thank you to everyone who's here today. And don't forget about carers. I'm sure there are lots of people in this room who would not identify as a carer, and actually when you think about it, you probably are, even if it's just for a few weeks or months. Take that away, if you think of how this piece of work can help people of your organisation, but also help yourselves, and if you ever need to be in that situation, what would the Carers Charter be able to do for you? I'm going to pass over to Nina. Thank you.